मेरी शायरी वायरी होती नहीं है, मैं तो अपने अचानक मेरे तैतु मेरे जमजे हैं, मुझे आता है तो मैं बोल देता हूँ। हाँ क्या बात है, क्या बात है, शायरी नहीं है जुगलबंदी है। मैं जो भी आप दिमाग में जो आ रही है, ये अगर आपने अपने खाने में ज्यादा डाला तड़का और ज्यादा डाला मसाला, दर्द होगा पेट में, याद आएगा मुखी लगड़ा वाला। जो ये मेरे दिल से निकली हुई बात है, चर्चा में आई है, बट कंग्रेचुलेशन सर फॉर दिस बुक एंड इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस। We need this book. It's coming at the right time with the right person, and hopefully we should follow it so as to stay away from a lot of problems. Congratulations once again. Thank you.
So what Nidhi said, I might as well tell you how this book is said. So how this book came about, like Reena said, inspiration just happened to give a glimpse here. I didn't take all the much faith and I didn't fire me. But now you all know where the inspiration came from. So the other thing I want to say is that I was asked yesterday again why this book came about, and most people know me as the butcher around town. But I thought that rather than cutting people's tummies and making them lose weight, I do know that maybe 10% or less than 10% of people need my help. But more than 90% of the people probably don't know how to eat right. And we've been working on this book for the last 8 or 9 months, and we find the really big that these girls try this recipe on. So every time there's a recipe that needs to be tried on, I'm the first guy who puts his hand up. Because I'm always on a perpetual diet, alright? On a perpetual program that I want to lose weight. Just a few days back, we had a session, in, a team meeting session, and on that, I needed to try and. Rosie, you can come and sit, please. Because this is a lecture that I'm giving. So I kind of challenged myself, because I said that being as busy as most of us are, and I can see Pranani is here as well, and I bet I would love to challenge her to this one as well. Because I said that being as busy as our schedules are, we never get seem to get time to go to the gym and exercise as much as some of the other people do. We never seem to get time to eat and meals at the right time. So I took this challenge and I went up to, I posted it on my Facebook and I said I've developed 6 packs by my birthday, that's what I put. And I went to Salman and said, now Ned, you need to help me. So he just looked at me and started laughing, saying, Doc, what's wrong with you? So I said, no, I need to do this, because if I can do this, I will tell people that you don't have to spend 3 hours in the gym to try and be as fit. And I promise you that all I've done is I've started eating healthy, very, very healthy. I probably, I'm following whatever the gym I'm going to, and it's not a lot. And I've not been able to go to the gym as much as I would love to, because I planned on finishing at 9 and I'm really dog tired by the time I start at 7:30 in the morning. And so I thought, what else to do? So the easiest and the most specific out thing that I can tell all of you guys is carry a pair of running shoes and carry a pair of running shoes. just run wherever you are in the world. You'll always need to find talent. You can run at 10 o'clock at night, you can run at 6 o'clock in the morning, and there's nobody to stop you. And that's what he was saying, that I tried to do this, so I was on a little boys trip to Europe some time back, and I ran in every city of Holland. My golf watch was my friend. So it became quite, it's fun. You can have your friends, and you can keep entertaining yourself. But you find whatever you are passionate about and do that as some form of business activity. And trust me, you'll do this for the rest of your life. This book also tells you about a few of the myths about eating, wrong eating. Most of us believe that it's the most healthy thing in the world to have green tea, right? Now, how many of us know that we are not supposed to have green tea immediately after a meal, but we all do it? Because that's a myth. So we've written about some of these medical myths that I've clarified. I thought let's put a medical perspective to some of these nutritional facts that not too many of us are aware of. We've also written a lot about healthy foods and superfoods which are available so easily and so cheaply in India. Things like jawar, things like bajra, things like spinach. And most of us actually go out and look for kale and various other things that are available abroad and even extremely expensive in India. But we never look at the most basic thing that is available. So we've tried to make really healthy recipes. And the bottom line, which I told these girls at the end of this, Desi, you're always late.
On time.
Come. So, what I told these girls is that eating food should, healthy food should not be a bore. It should not be something that you go against. It should be something that you love to do on a day-to-day basis. So, I said that healthy food can be yummy. It doesn't necessarily mean you have to have only one cucumber or you have to have only this. And that's how what we put down in this book. I hope you love reading this book because we've really enjoyed writing this book. And, I hope you become as fit as a human man.
So, thank you, Kambli, for joining us. And also, the lovely Narma who's sitting here and refuses to come up on stage. But to begin with, I am also going to call the girls that Mufi keeps talking about, and that is Kala and Neha. They're the two dietitians in really the left hand and the right hand, and the pillars behind this book, Kala and Neha, please, Mufi keeps talking about how he's been the guinea pig. So, I want you to tell me one recipe of yours, Kala, that he absolutely loved. Yeah. What does he want? Which one did he like? Which one is his favorite?
Well, you know, it's very easy with Dr. Mufi because he's very motivating and it's always, even if he didn't like something too well, he's like, this is good, but maybe we could just, you know, tweak down that a little bit and give us the advice or the recipes, but it was not too difficult to convince him otherwise, so it was not too bad.
Okay. Now, Neha, I have to ask you, Mufi is a non-vegetarian for the most part. I know he likes veggies, but he doesn't like
so what vegetarian recipe works for himself? So as Kamil rightly said that with her everything works, so he's never not a fussy eater. So anything, in fact most of the Gujarati dishes and anything that we offer him, he's always up for.
Okay. So now you know the ladies who are behind the weight loss and behind transforming so many of us. I've also been on it.
That's what the theme is. But it's good to be good, it's good to be be a part here now, and in fact, I know Mufi very years back. Now, everybody's calling him sir. What is that strategy behind that? Calling you sir? Oh, yeah, okay. No, it's in fact, I've read only three books in my life. First is in my school, fortunately. Second one was the Mind and Subject.